Dr. David Kimbro and Dr. Randall Hughes work to unlock the secrets of the intertidal zone, where the land meets the sea.
Randall and David have a mission.
One thing that we've been interested in is how predators affect their prey, not just by eating them, but just by being present.
By its mere presence, a predator can scare an animal and affect its behavior. But in the turbid waters that often surround oyster reefs and salt marshes, how do the prey know to be scared?
And so there are a number of different ways they can do that. They can, you know, physically bump into their prey and let them know that they're there. But in marine systems, one of the semi-unique ways that prey can learn that their predators are around is because most of these predators give off chemicals off of their bodies that float in the water, and prey can detect them. They can basically smell them, for lack of a better term.
These cues are key to many of Randall and David's experiments. This box blue crab can't eat nearby periwinkle snails, but the snails can sense it. Likewise, these oysters are safe in their cages, but mud crab cues can keep them from eating and affect their health. But there is another potential kind of cue that they hadn't considered.
These fish predators on these oyster reefs make a lot of noise. Both drum and catfish just vocalize for various reasons. And so this was kind of a fun idea to think about how to test.
What had started out as a fun side project became somewhat more involved. They had to find out, can mud crabs hear?
This is a black drum.
If they can hear, do they respond to predator cues? And finally,
which effect is stronger, the effect of these cues coming through the water or the effect of these catfish sounds?
So can mud crabs hear? Stay tuned.
In the Grass on the Reef is funded by the National Science Foundation.